Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the City of Healing. This is your sister, Sanantra Angela. Wanted to come forth and share what I'm wearing today, just in case you're interested. I will share a walk to show my entire outfit after this video, and separate from this video as well, just in case you're interested and you want to actually see the whole outfit, you want to hear what I'm wearing and inspiration of it. Here we go. Let's start with this beautiful scarf. I don't remember where I got it, but the inspiration of it is that I love scarves. I collect scarves. I go somewhere, I'm gonna get something, it's probably a scarf. If someone asked me what I want from somewhere that they're going, I was like, well, a scarf. So I have a collection, a plethora of scarves. And this particular one, I don't remember where I got it from, but I believe it was somewhere local. It has the taupe in it. It has the bronze in it, some blues, some copper, and some tans. Beautiful scarf, mulberry, they say satin. Anyway, it's very soft, silky, like beautiful side. I wanted to wear it today as a shirt. It's nothing new. I used to do it a lot a long time ago. And one lesson that I learned when wearing these silk or satin or mulberry scarves, that you have to wear a bantu underneath it or some type of tube top underneath it, as evidenced by how to wear one of these scarves as a shirt. I had this crush on this gentleman way back in middle school through high school. We go off, we meet up later on, both of us in our 40s or whatever, and we start dating. I was like, wow, so lucky. You know, he was all that back then, he was all that back, you know, when we were dating. And one time we went on this date, and we were, I think, at a mall, really nice mall. And he looked down at me because he's like 6'3". He was like, peekaboo. And I looked up, I was like, oh my God, he's so romantic. I was like, peekaboo, you know? And all I can remember basically was his hand coming towards me to pull up my scarf, and me looking down and seeing one of my breast out. Oh my gosh, you know, it's like I'm thinking just total embarrassment. But anyway, the moral of that story, you just can't wear it without some type of tube top or some covering underneath it. I'm not, as I mentioned before, an underwear type of person, but that was a big lesson, that you cannot wear these without something underneath it, because, you know, I just did that then, and that will never happen again. But that was a lesson from him, you know, may he rest in peace. But anyway, wanted to share that, you know, scars, beautiful scars, to basically, you know, stylish, high-end, low-end, you know, sentimental scars can be worn as shirts, different types of ways. You can be really creative with them. You can tie them. You can Velcro them. You can pin them. I just do it. I also wear them as, you can wear them as dresses. You can be really creative with multiple scarves at a time. You can tie them together. Just so many things that you can do with a scarf. And I decided to pair it today with these pair of jeans that I got maybe a week ago. I was at the mall with one of my best friends. Like I said, I don't need to buy anything. But I saw these, I saw the sign that says 60% off, and all these nice jeans were there. I don't need any more jeans, but I don't have any jeans like this. So, and I actually saw some high-end jeans like this, like on Farfetch, I think maybe a couple of months ago, for like $200-something. But let me tell you, these jeans, I believe, were $26, $28, and they are very nice quality jeans. They not, you know, the highest end, the best jeans that I have, but they are very stretchy, you know, very figure flattering, nice jeans, different. I don't have anything like this, so like, why not? The shoes, these shoes, got them from my favorite place to get shoes, Amazon, and they are like a snake print. I fell in love with these, and of course, as usual, I get them a little big. And my ankle, as usual, is very small. because you see they're not necessarily strap up, I mean lace up, but they are like strap up, and you know, because the jeans are a little high and the shoes come up a little higher, you'll see what I'm talking about as I walk and you can see the outfit. And that's basically, you know, the clothes wise for the outfit. I really like this outfit. One of my favorite types of outfits really is to wear a nice scarf tied in a really nice way and some nice jeans and maybe some heels or some cute sandals. I think it's just a perfect outfit. Just don't forget your top underneath or some type of a tube top or something, unless you want to play peekaboo. And my jewelry, I decided to highlight with silver jewelry, nothing exciting. And these sunglasses, you probably can't see the details of it, but as I mentioned, I'm wearing these snake print sandals, platforms, and I was considering, you know, wearing my snake print sunglasses, but I say no. Nobody probably noticed but me, but the little snakes, silver snakes on them, you know, clear, transparent sunglasses, dark eye, thought it was kind of different to do, and maybe no one will probably notice, but, you know, I will, so I thought it was pretty interesting to do, and that's basically what I'm wearing. Oh yeah, I don't have on makeup. It's too hot for makeup. I did, however, put on one of my favorite lipstick, which is from Citizens, and the name of it is Stockholm, and I line my lip with Sephora's Molasses, not eyeliner, but lip liner. And let's talk about the perfume of the day. You ready? Now, this perfume is one of my favorites, and it's by Jo Malone. I did a haul on it long, long time ago with some of my favorite Jo Malone perfume. I have since given them some away when I thought that I was trying to be a minimalist. Now I have to regroup and kind of purchase them again, maybe. But this is one of my favorites. Pomegranate Noir. I love this perfume. I've gotten such compliments from it, such as it smells like fruit punch on a full moon, fruity pebbles, bubble gum, and maybe all of those are correct, but you know, this perfume I think is very fruity and mysterious. I got the big bottle. This bottle is at least 2 years old and it's very long lasting. Most Jo Malone's colognes have the reputation of not lasting long, but this is the one, even though it's clear, unlike the darker bottles, they are probably more longer lasting or more intense. But this right here is very long lasting. Love it. Now, if it don't last that long for you and you want it to even last even longer, you might as well get the body cream to go with it. This right here, it smells just like it. Most of her body creams don't smell too much or as strong as the perfume, but this does. It screams the pomegranate. It screams the guaiacwood. It screams the patchouli, but it doesn't say it has patchouli in this. Most importantly, I think that this perfume is more fruity, not necessarily sweet. Sort of like your Hawaiian punch without the sugar added to it. That's how it smells to me. However, if you want some sweetness to it, because most people are more used to the vanilla, the gourmand type of scents, and not the necessarily fruity, mysterious scents. One of my other favorite perfumes or body sprays from Brazilian Crush or Soleil de Janeiro is 71. 71 is my absolute favorite. And if you want to sweeten this up some, and I didn't wear it today because I just wanted to be more fruity, not necessarily too sweet. But if you want to sweeten this up after your shower, while you scrub down, you oil down, and you add the 71, it sticks with you. It's long lasting. It's beautiful. I mean, it's so gourmand smelling. and you let that soak in, and then you put on your body cream and then your spray, and then put you some spray on your clothing. I mean, nobody else is gonna smell like you, and people are gonna ask you what you're wearing. Anyway, just wanted to come forth and share what I'm wearing today, just in case you're interested. Hope that you all have a wonderful rest of your Saturday. Until next time, take care.
Refugee camp, conspiracy theory, what? Yeah, what? You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. And long last love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Caught in the way that I stand. There's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me weak. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel